Hi guys, what's up and welcome back. For today's video, I have the biggest epic Ulta haul ever. I mean, I think it's pretty big. I mean, the money part was pretty big, but I like the stuff that I picked up. So this is basically a whole bunch of trips. I did purchase a few things online. I did go in store as well. It's part of the holiday stuff as well. And I did include a whole bunch of stuff from the 21 Days of Beauty that Ulta does have, which I believe is over now. So let's get started. Everything I could find, I will leave linked down below. And any video that I did do on any of these products, I'll leave linked down below if you guys wanna check that out. So the first product that I did pick up, which I did do a review on yesterday, and this is the Lorac Mega Pro Palette 3. The palette is not in here. I left it downstairs, but I'll leave the video down below. I love this palette so much. It's so essential. It has everything you would ever want to create that neutral look, but also has like your pops of color, but also like your deepened colors as well to make any smoky eye look totally dramatic and gorgeous. So I really, really love this, and it's definitely one of my favorite palettes that has released during the holiday season. So, A plus for that. The next holiday product that I did pick up, I guess we're going to do holiday stuff first, is this Christmas in New York Too Faced set. So that's basically how it looks, and this is the Ulta exclusive one. I really, really like the packaging. It's really cute, pretty small. The color is so adorable, and I like how like normal size it is, like it's a good small size, you know? And then once you open it up, that's how the interior part looks. A girl skating on Rockefeller Center. I never went there, can you just imagine? Even though I live like 10 blocks away. No, 20 minutes away, but still. And then you receive a really beautiful palette in here, which I really do like actually. Very impressed with the quality. You are receiving a whole bunch of neutralized shades in there. Very small, compact, good for every day, you know, the norm pretty much. So this is the Christmas in New York Ulta exclusive set, which I really, really like. All right, the next product that I did pick up from Ulta, which is going literally straight back. I mean, I don't want to be rude about it, but I just really didn't like it. I know a few people did, and if you did like it, then I'm really actually very happy for you because maybe I got a dud, I don't know, but I don't like this palette. Anyway, this is the Ulta exclusive Tarte palette, and once you open it up over here, there are a whole bunch of shades just like that. The packaging is freaking adorable, but I just feel like the product inside is not like, not that good, I would say. And then there's a little drawer on the side as well, which does include a whole bunch of little stuff. You have a blush, bronzer, and highlight in this baby palette, a TARDIS lip gloss, a TARDIS mascara, a brush, and all that good stuff. So this is the Ulta exclusive set that will be returned. Anyways, the next product that I did pick up is this Buxom Six Below Sexy set. I really, really do love the Buxom sets. They have released a whole bunch of other ones as well on Sephora site too. I'm contemplating on getting them. Let me know if you guys want to see a review and lip swatch video on it, but this is basically what I picked up from Buxom lip gloss section, I would say. And I really, really do like this. I think it's so essential for the holiday season. You get your really nice reds and neutralized colors with bomb-ass glitter. It's like anything you would ever really want. So, really, really like this. And it's a pretty good deal as well. So, the next holiday product that I did pick up is this Christmas in New York Grand Hotel Cafe little house palette. So, that's how it looks. I think it's really, really cute. I usually do pick these up every single year because I just think it's just too cute to pass up on. And once you open it up, this is how the little house looks. I think it's adorable. You just pop the cover off and then you open the doors right over here. And then you are receiving three little palettes with a mascara down there as well. Better Than Sex mascara. So you are receiving the three palettes that look just like this. I think these are so adorable. It says to and from the back, on the back. And you can give this out to somebody for a gift or you can keep it for yourself. I just think it's so cute. So I will be doing a in-depth review on this little set. So I'm not going to go through each one because we have so much more things to cover. And this video would be 77 years long. So that is the next one. Then my next thing that I picked up, which I love so, so much, Smashbox. I love you. So this is the Smashbox Light It Up Blush Contour and Highlighting Palette. I did do a review on this and you guys know that I'm obsessed. Smashbox is killing it, like literally. So once you open it up, it does come in this really nice large black sized palette. It's huge and beautiful. And then when you pop the actual palette open, Okay, there's a really huge mirror right there, and then you are receiving a whole bunch of shades just like that. Mainly blushes and highlighters and one kind of like bronzier shade, but I think that this is beautiful. It's massive and it's affordable, you know, compared to how much products you actually get in here. So I really, really like that, and definitely an awesome, awesome buy. Okay, so now onto the products that are not holiday related, which I'm so excited to share with you guys because they're pretty, pretty good shit. All right, so I did stuff a whole bunch of stuff in here, and then I have another box here as well. Sit tight, we have a long ride to go. All right, so the next thing that I did pick up is this Maybelline Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser. So, I honestly really wanted to try this. I know this came out ages ago, but I wanted to see if it compares to any other, like, primers I have. And I like to use primers that, like, help with my pore situation going on. And this is, like, pore, like, instant pore eraser. So I figured me and the pores, like, best friends. So this could probably work out. I do like the consistency. I love the packaging. It's so cute, and I kind of just wanted it in my drawers, to be honest. It's so cute. And the next product that I picked up is this Maybelline Brow Precise Micro Pencil Micro Crayon Eyebrow Pencil type of thing. And this is in soft brown. I didn't try it yet. I didn't open it up yet either. It looks pretty light for these brows, you know what I mean? But I guess I'll play around with it and see what's up. I heard good things about this, so I wanted to test it out. Maybe compare it to some other good stuff that I have. Okay, and then the next one I picked up is this Essence Mascara. This is how it came. It didn't have an actual package, so I'm like, okay. But I heard amazing things about this as well. And I don't know. It looks really nice. It's pretty massive, I would say, for a mascara. Like, it's a big-ass bottle. But let's see. I like the packaging. It's really nice. Okay. It looks pretty regular and standard. So that's how the wand looks. I did want to test this out and see what's up, because I heard that when you use this, your lashes look like you have fake lashes on. So I'm like, let me see if this works for me. And I'm excited. So Essence Lash Princess Mascara is next. The next product that I do have here is this Sally Hansen Little Baby Tweezers. So I did pick this up in store. Nothing major, nothing special. But of course, when you're in Ulta or Sephora, everything is pure visible and you feel like you have a beard on. Do you know what I mean? Not really, but you know. So I felt like this was essential. It was like $5 and it saved my life that day. Next two things that I did pick up are these two Lorac Light Source Illuminating Highlighters. So those are the two shades that I did pick up. I did want to pick up a few other ones as well, but the lady at the counter was like, I'm sorry, you can only pick up two. And I'm like, well, why? So I'm like, shit. But I'm like, maybe it's for the best. I don't have to spend so much money. But I really, really wanted to try these out because I think that they're fabulous. They're amazing, beautiful, gorgeous colors. And I don't hear a lot of people talking about these. Plus, they were on sale for $11 at that time. So I'm like, I must. The first one that I did pick up is in the shade Starlight. And this is how the packaging looks. Fairly simple, nothing special or major. It has like a magnetic closure. And that is how the shade looks. I think it's so damn beautiful. It actually looks gorgeous on the skin. It's not like anything special in the pan, but look at that. Kill me now, please. That is so damn beautiful. It doesn't have any shimmer or anything like that. It just has a gorgeous, like, it's kind of like matte in a way, but not really. It looks awesome on the skin. That's what I have to say. Okay, and then the next one that I did pick up is the pinkier one, which is Moonlight. And I felt like these two shades would suit my skin because I have lighter skin. And the other ones were a little bit darker. So, this is how the shade looks. It has like a pinky, purpley undertone to it. But it looks amazing on. It's very unique and not like anything I really own. So, that is how it swatches. Just like that. So, those are definitely my two pretty much favorite products that I did pick up during the sale. So the next thing that I do have here, I'm telling you, this is just going to keep going and going. Like, I have so much more stuff in this bag. This is the Hey Honey Take It Off Exfoliating Honey Peel Off Mask. So that is how it looks. I haven't tried anything from this brand. And I just thought this was interesting. They also had this on sale at the time. It was $20 at the time. Normally it's like $32, and I'm like, what? Who would buy this for $32? Anyways, it says it's for all skin types, and it says it's kind of, and it's basically kind of like an exfoliating mask that you put on your face, and then you wait like 15 minutes, and then you just like kind of peel it off. I will say, the peeling off part is such a sensational feeling. You feel like, I don't know, it just feels like you're taking all the shit out of your face, you know what I mean? Like in your pores and all that gunk and stuff like that. But, I don't know, when I put this on, it kind of like burned my eyes a little bit, even though it was not near my eyes. And I'm just like, does this have alcohol in here? And then I checked, and one of the ingredients is alcohol. So it's not the first one, but it's still there. And I don't love to put that on my face. I feel like it just irritates it more. So I'm kind of like on and off with this. I still want to play with it a little bit more to see if it's still like it still works with my skin, but we'll see about this one. So that is that. Then I picked up a Urban Decay blush. Now, this was a funny story. I mean, it wasn't that funny, but basically, they had this on sale. Of course, everyone picked it up because really, these retail for $26. I can't imagine buying this thing for $26, but it was on sale for $13 at that time. Everything was obviously sold out. I did want to go to the store, but I didn't want to travel, like, how far? The closest one is, like, I don't know, 40 minutes away, and I'm like, it's not worth it, you know? So, it kept coming back in stock, out of stock, whatever, and the only one I was able to pick up was Fetish, which I think is a beautiful shade, but the packaging is so adorable. It has a magnetic closure, and I think it's beautiful. It's, like, that beautiful kind of, like, mauve-y color, which I think would be suitable for anytime, any day, any hour, any season. It's just so damn nice. So that's how it swatches, just like that. It's pretty light, I would say. You could build it up to a really major intensity, but I love this. Damn, I wish they would have had other ones in stock, but I'm happy with that, I guess. Okay, next thing that I did pick up, I mean, I don't need any more brow products for the life of mine. I love getting them. All right, so this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Powder Duo, and I got it in the shade Dark Brown. I was, like, standing at the counter at Ulta, and I was like, I don't know which shade I am. So I just chose this one. It seemed like it was okay. That is how the duo looks. It's okay. I mean, I don't love it, but I don't hate it. I still have to play around with it a little bit more. But it was half price at the time, so for half price, it was pretty worth it. Right, the next things that I did pick up are these Real Techniques sponges. So these look pretty interesting. I wanted to see, like, what this life was about, to see if they work, if they're, you know, comparable to anything like the Beauty Blender or anything good like that. So the first one is this one, which I thought it was a pretty unique shape. It's the Miracle Sculpting Sponge. I haven't tried this yet, and I purchased this, like, I think 3 weeks ago. And then this one is the Two Miracle Mini Eraser Sponges. So they were a pretty good deal as well. I think they were about $5 each. So I want to test them out and see what's up with it. And maybe I'll make a video. Let me know if you guys want to see one. Okay, and then the last thing I have in this Ulta bag are these e.l.f. Makeup Remover Cleansing Cloths. I just like to get these e.l.f. like cleansing cloths occasionally. I think they're great to remove swatches or randomly. I don't like to use them for my face at all. But, you know, for like cleaning up, hand swatches, you know, all that good stuff. It's affordable, $3, so it gets the job done. So I like to have like at least one on hand at times. So I only picked up one. I don't know why I didn't pick up more, but that was that. Then, I'm just trying to show the side that you guys cannot see my address, even though I know you guys want to come over one day, Dorian. Okay, so this is the next box that I have. Actually, the only box that I do have left. And the first thing that I have in this actual box is this Clean and Clear Morning Burst Facial Cleanser. So, I love this cleanser to death. To absolute death. I just finished one in a different, like, color. I like to switch up the colors occasionally. And I was like, I need to get this again. Ulta sells it, so I'm like, awesome. Oh my god, this just smells like literal flowers. Like the opening of the gates of heaven and you're just walking outside. This is what you basically smell. I just love this to use anytime at night, during the day, like in the morning. Just to clean off my face, to feel more awake. Just, it doesn't do anything major, but I love it so much. And it's pretty affordable, so I like it. Okay, the next two things that I did pick up are lashes. So the first one is from the brand Kardashian Beauty. And I don't know what I'm showing you guys here, but I did use these already like 3-4 times in some of my videos. I like these, but I'm not obsessed with them. I think they're okay. Like, that's it. It's just okay. And then this one is the Allure Dramatic number 205 lashes. So I haven't tried this brand ever, and I haven't tried these styles, like this style ever, like in any brand. So I wanted to see what's up with it, to see how dramatic it looks and all that good stuff. All right. The next thing that I did pick up is from Clean & Clear as well. And they did have buy one, get one half off, so that's why I picked up these two. I don't think I've ever tried this in my life. I heard pretty good things about it, but this is the Advantage Acne Spot Treatment with Salicylic Acid and Acne Medication. So, it's a pretty large, massive size. I don't know if this has alcohol or what the situation is with this, but I have acne at times. I mean, come on. Where is it? Over here? I don't know. Like, you know, you get breakouts once in a while. Or always. Me. So, I just like to have these kind of things on hand whenever I have the patience to put it on. Or if I'm feeling it, you know, just to like have it. Alright, so we're almost done here. I have a few products left. So I did pick up a few of these Shea Sugar Tree Hut scrubs. So I really, really love these. They're so affordable. They're around usually like $6-$7. They last the longest time. They exfoliate your body. You feel like a princess after. And they smell so damn freaking ass good. So the first one that I did pick up is this one. And this is Moroccan Rose. I haven't smelled these because these I purchased online. But I do like them. Like, they're good. Whoa. Oh my god. Oh my god. It smells like a perfume that my teacher used to wear, like, in elementary. But not an old lady kind of smell or anything. But shit. It smells so good. Yo, you guys gotta get this one. The Moroccan Rose. If you smell this ever, please let me know if you love it as much as I do. The next one that I picked up is this Treha Chai Sugar Marula and Jasmine. I don't really know. And I like the color. It's a really nice yellow. This smells pretty damn good too. Oh my god, they know their stuff. I don't know. It just smells so freaking good. Yeah, it has a little bit of like a lemony scent, but not overpowering. And I love this. Really, really nice. And then the last one that I did pick up from this brand is Amazonian Pakai. I know that's not how you say it, but we'll go with it for now. And this one, amazing, amazing. It has like that really nice fruity scent, so beautiful. I love this. I can't wait to like slather this all over my body, like literally the whole thing. All right, so we're down to the last thing, and I'm telling you guys, once I actually finish the video, I'm gonna find like 12 more things and I'll be like, shoot. Anyways, the next and final thing I picked up is from Estee Lauder, and this is the Advanced Night Micro Cleansing Balm. This was $45, but I heard such good things about this, and I was like, I don't really love to use facial towelettes to the most part. I feel like they could be harsh on the skin, no matter really like which brand I use. But I like cleansing balms and oils because I feel like they remove your makeup like this. And it's not harsh, do you know what I mean? So this is how the product looks once you take it out. I have used this a few times. It's really beautiful packaging, very luxurious feeling, and I must say, like, one second. This is how much product I use already, and you literally need the teeniest amount ever. Wow. Wow. Never have I ever tried anything like this in my 24 years of living on this earth. Wow. If you guys want to see a demo and review on this, let me know. I would be so excited to do it because your eyes are going to just be like in another world. This works like a miracle worker. So, oh, is it miracle? No, it doesn't say miracle. It should say that the title, miracle worker. Anyways, that's pretty much everything I did pick up from Ulta. If you guys have any products you guys want me to do a review on, lip swatches and those kind of stuff, then you can let me know below. And I guess I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.